These days, the C word is not so much cancer itself, but rather cure. Many researchers say these days we do not really expect to be able to totally eliminate cancer from our lives, but that does not mean giving up the fight. Inside Mass General's Cancer Center lab, researchers use a machine to look for signs of cancer in the blood of a patient already diagnosed,
so that we can figure out what treatment is best for them.
And in the future, this technology might be used more widespread, testing nearly everyone's blood to catch cancer tumors before they're diagnosed.
Because if you find an early cancer and you can cut it out before it spreads, you're cured.
The head of the cancer center says blood test technology does look promising, but right now these tests still produce too many false positives.
And if you have a mistake and you tell someone they have cancer when they don't, that can be very, very difficult.
We've made real progress with cancers.
5 decades ago, John Wayne and the American Cancer Society promised to cure cancer within one lifetime. These days, researchers are more cautious.
Fully curing cancer would be a difficult thing to do. But there's certainly room to improve cancer mortality or deaths.
Kate Weissman says her cervical cancer diagnosis would have been a death sentence 50 years ago. Instead, she's been cancer-free for 6 years and recently had a baby daughter, who Weissman now believes will likely see a cure for cancer in her lifetime.
I think right now we are just planting the seeds, and you know, my daughter and her generation and the generation after her are going to stand in the shade of the trees that we've planted.
A full study on how well these blood tests work to find cancer could take 10 years or more, but some of the biotech companies developing the test don't want to wait that long. They want the federal government to fast-track the approval process. Live in Charlestown, David Beanick, WCVB News Center 5.